Welcome. Today we're going to track down all negative and positive sum balances that exceed a certain threshold amount. At my job, I had this task: find all the stores where the sum of all invoices for each store are not on balance. So, if a store exceeds a certain threshold amount, positive as well as negative, we want to send it to control. As our dataset included plus 3 million rows and 2,000 stores, a DAX measure summing all the amount for each store and evaluating the balances is the best approach. So, let's look at that. In this dataset, we have 650,000 rows and 2,000 stores. We have the columns StoreID, invoice number, transaction date, and amount, and we want to find all the stores where the balance deviates more than $1,000, both positive and negative. The easiest and fastest way is to create a dummy measure with the outputs accepted or control. As we want the threshold amount to be adjustable, we start by adding threshold amount as a variable. This is done by adding VAR, the name of the variable, equal sign, and the threshold amount. When we have declared a variable in a formula, we need to add a return statement, otherwise Power BI will run us an error. As this return statement is binary, we use the if function here. Because we use a measure, we can make a sum of all amounts for each store and apply it to our table. First, we evaluate whether the sum amounts are larger than the threshold of $1,000. Next, we add our OR operators and evaluate whether sum amounts are smaller than threshold times minus 1, meaning minus $1,000. We start by removing the irrelevant columns, and we can then add our measure to our table and evaluate whether the threshold has been exceeded, positively or negatively. Based on this dummy measure, we hide all the stores that can be accepted on face value and leave the rest to manual review. If we have multiple tables where we need to do the same evaluation, we should change this threshold to a parameter. We add a parameter by pressing Transform Data and New Parameter. Here we set the value to the threshold amount and click Enable Load. Otherwise, we can't use the threshold parameter in our DAX formula. We then replace the threshold value with max table name and column name, in this case threshold value and threshold value. After adding some comments to the formula, we can copy paste the DAX statement to other tables and use the same parameter as evaluation criteria. With this approach, our threshold value will always be correct and easily adjustable, no matter how many times we have used it throughout our report.